Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Now let us say what is the channel, what is continuous channels and channel capacity theorem and all. So first, what is channel capacity theorem? So in the this is also called as Shannon-Hartley law also. So let us come to the introduction part. Here the waveform received at the receiver is corrupted by the random process called noise. So when something received, like some wave is getting received to a device, it will definitely be corrupted due to any noise. It can be some thermal noise or some any manual disturbances or something like that. So there will be some noises. They are random process because we can't predict them how it will be. So we call it as random process. And by which it is corrupted, it is called noise. So first, different types of noise. Johnson noise also called as thermal noise, and we call this thermal Johnson noise as white noise because the power spectral intensity of a thermal noise or a Johnson noise will be constant. Okay, so that's why it is called white noise. Now this is due to the thermal motion of electrons. Now entity noise, when noise adds to the signal. Now fading noise, when noise multiplied to the signal. And these are the three types. And now in this channel, the noise is almost white and it is distributed, which is resembles Gaussian, which is zero mean and some variance. Hence, it is also called as additive white Gaussian noise. So that's why this random process is looking like a Gaussian distribution. So that's why you call it as a white Gaussian noise, additive, because this will be added to the signal. Okay. Now coming to the statements of Shannon-Hartley law. So Shannon-Hartley law, also called as Shannon-Todd theorem, states that the capacity of band limit Gaussian channel with AWGN is given as, this is the formula here, C is the channel capacity that can be found by using with the channel bandwidth in hertz. Now S by N ratio, signal to noise ratio. Okay, if they give the individual values of S and N, that S is in watts, okay, signal power in watts, and N is the noise power in watts. So this N can be rewritten as eta B. So eta is the power spectral density of noise. Okay, but this is like N by, like the in exams they will give as N by 2 watts. Okay, so power spectral density of noise, N by 2 is equal to 10 power minus 40, like that. So then from that eta will be 2 times of 10 power minus 40, like that. We need to calculate and substitute. So this units of the channel bandwidth, the channel capacity is bits per second. Okay, basically how the channel can transmit, the rate at which it can transmit. So Shannon-Hartley law, that it is possible to transmit over a channel and a bandwidth B H corrupted by AWGN at a rate of C bits per second. Okay, we have a channel with a bandwidth B and corrupted by AWGN noise at a rate of C bits per second, which an arbitrarily small probability of error if the signal is encoded in such a manner that the smaller are Gaussian signals, samples are Gaussian signals. So what he is saying is, with an arbitrary is error signal encoded in such a way that a manner that can samples are all Gaussian samples or Gaussian signals. So he is saying that he will encode the signal in such a manner that all the samples will be looking like a Gaussian signal itself. That's how he will encode it. Now coming to the first implication. So this first implication states that when observe this formula, that equation, we can see that as the B increases, channel also it is directly proportional at B and C. So we can conclude that B increases means C also increases. But we need to observe the other parameters also, because here N can be written as eta B. So this parameter will be decreased. So that too also you need to consider and you should conclude. So next, since R max is C, okay. Maximum rate is we will term it as C because the channel will have the maximum capacity without error to transmit something without error at the so R max should be less than or equal to C. So R should be less than or equal to C. So from that we conclude that R is equal to C, like that. So however, the channel capacity due to does not be, become infinite when the bandwidth is made infinite. So he is saying that if you use the channel of infinite bandwidth, but the bandwidth is not like infinite bandwidth. Sorry, that if you made a channel capacity infinite, even if you made the channel capacity infinite, the channel bandwidth will not be infinite. Okay, and also you can see in a real life, there is nothing infinite term because everything will be infinite only. But this is because B increases. See, I told you this as n also, no? As B increases, the n which depends on B also increases. Okay, as n is directly proportional to B, that reduces the S by n. So this will, as this increases, this S by n will automatically get reduced. So there will be some balance. We can say it's a trade-off between these two, right? So now coming to what he is saying, coming to what will be, so how to find an infinite capacity? So for to at what value of beta we'll get an infinite like that. So to find the infinite capacity, what we'll do, we just substituted n as n beta, and now we just multiply and divide with S by n, and just this is log, no? We just take this term to the numerator, and this it becomes like 1 plus this S by eta b whole power eta b s, and we just consider this term as x. Okay, this entire term as x, so it will be looking like log of 1 plus x into e power 1 by x. So we can directly write this 1 plus x whole power 1 by x as e. Okay, as we how we, because this term, now what we call, this is a channel. Still, it is not infinite. It is just for channel only, right? For to find the channel capacity only, this formula is made. Now we want to find C infinite. So according when B infinite, x tends to zero, right? So limit C when B is equal to B tends to infinity. So automatically x tends to zero. Then we apply both limits on both sides. We just replace this term as C infinity. Now just send this limit outside because into inside, because S by eta is a constant, and then what we got this term. This term is written as E. So finally C infinity is equals to B into S by N log E base 2 bits per second. So in this subject, whenever there is a E without any base, it is by default is 2. Okay, base 2. So we need to remember that. Anywhere here also it is base 2 only. In this form also it is base 2. So now coming to the second implication, that is bandwidth and S by N ratio trade-off. What he is saying, that he is taking, first initially he is taking some random values, that is S by N as 7 and B1 as 4 kilohertz, substituted, and we got a channel capacity as 12 kilobits per second. But if I want to have the same capacity with the different value of S by N, so that is like we fixed this channel capacity, and we want to know, we have increased this S by N to it is 7, and we increase it to 15. Okay, to 15. Now find the bandwidth of the channel. So it got decreases. So here for this like when the S by N is 7, the B is 4. When S by is 15, the B is 3. As we know that those are inversely proportional that we got here. So from this, when you draw a plot a graph, okay, when you plot a graph, it will be like a decreasing curve. Okay. Now exponentially decaying. Now what he is observing here, he was observing how much change we need to bring in the signals so that to maintain the same channel capacity. So he just done the same. He found n1 and n2, and he considered s2 by n2 by s1 by n2. That is, he is doing the SNR ratios for first case and the second case, and we got s2 by s1 as 1.6. So this is that means S2 is equal to 1.6 times of S1. That means how much change is there? 0.6. 0.6 means 60%, right? So thus the 25% reduction in bandwidth of 4 kilohertz to 3 kilohertz. So basically, when the SNR is previously 4, now it is 3, so the change is 25%. So basically, how 1 by 4 into 100, like that. So change 4 minus 3 by 4 into 100, like that he wrote. So that is 25%. Now requires 60% approximate increase in the signal power. So to have this change, even if you have this change of 25%, and we need to remain this channel capacity same, we need to increase this percent as 60%. We need to increase. That's what he say. 60% increase in signal power. Okay. Let us have a exact significance by drawing the trade-off curve. So this is the trade-off curve. Here this x-axis represents the S by N bandwidth to S by N. Okay, and now now this y-axis is a BYC. that's all, like SNR ki, SNR for SNR and BYC we are plotting a curve. This is looking like this. Okay, next here let's come to a problem. So 1 minute.